Just a little while ago, I uploaded a video tutorial on how to add a content delivery network service to your WordPress-based website, and I totally forgot to do one thing that was probably the most important thing to do, and thank goodness one of the subscribers on the channel reminded me and said, hey, what about this? So here's the video. I'll put a link in the video description box, and I'll also pin it to the pinned comment area. And so it's a full video tutorial. And right here, Kyle, he's from Ogle Web. I should put a link to his website as well. He's a website developer. He said, what kind of speed difference are we talking? Got any before and after numbers? And so he posted that, and he just pointed out the thing that I totally did not add that to the video, which is a before and after. So I'm going to go and do that right now. I did do a before and after test. And so he actually then went and followed the tutorial, added a content delivery network, the same service that I showed in the video, to one of his development websites. And his tests were that it loaded a second faster. So just by doing this one simple thing, it shaved off 1 second off of his load time. And I would definitely say that is a win, especially considering adding a content delivery network really is just a matter of a few pennies per month, depending on the website. So here is the website I used in the tutorial, and I went and added Bunny CDN. It's just a very affordable, high-performance CDN. It'll only cost you a few pennies per month. You'll learn about that in the video. So let me show you the before and the after. Now, all I did was take the URL to this website, and I haven't really done anything with this website. So here you can see it's just some images and some text and all that. Now, none of the images or anything have been through any optimizations or anything like that. I just took the URL and I put it in Pingdom. Pingdom has a speed test tool. And so I went ahead and I put it in Pingdom, and it's for the before and the after. So let's just go ahead and look at the before. I'm not doing this live on purpose, because sometimes, let me just say, speed tests can vary, meaning you'll do it three times. You really probably want to take the average of the three. So here is the non-CDN stats from Pingdom. So you see a snapshot of the image right there. Now, I'm using InMotion hosting for this website, and I'm also using the Astra WordPress theme and one of their Astra starter sites. And I have Lifter LMS, all kinds of stuff on this website. So the performance grade, because Astra is already very optimized, is just came in at 90%, a load time of 3.36 seconds, which is not great. It's good, but it's not great. But like I said, there's been no optimizations at all done on this website. And so here's its thing there. Okay, and then after, this is the score I got after. So it went from that 3.3 seconds down to 1.3 seconds. So it actually shaved off 2 seconds. And that's pretty huge when you consider it was already loading pretty snappy to begin with. So to go from that down to 1.3 seconds, it's pretty fabulous if you ask me. But like I said, your mileage may vary. YMMV. I'm not saying that everyone that adds this CDN to their WordPress website are going to have these massive gains. However, 1 second, 2 seconds shaved off an already quick load time is a huge, huge win. If you took it into percentages, it's loading over twice as fast with this one little thing that really just costs a few pennies. So anyways, if you watched that video and decided to take the plunge and add a content delivery network to your WordPress-based website, I'd like to hear your results in the comment section down below. And if you didn't watch that video, it's a full tutorial, I will have a link in the video description box down below. It's definitely something worth checking out. You can see in the video that it would really, for my website with the ton of traffic that I get, it's going to probably cost me less than $1 per month to have a content delivery network. I think most websites, it might cost 5 to 10 cents per month to have a content delivery network on their website. So if your web host doesn't provide it, and most of the shared hosting doesn't, you usually only get it with managed WordPress hosting. It's definitely the best nickel you can spend per month to add a content delivery network to your website. Hey, if you're not familiar with the channel here, consider clicking on the subscribe button. Give it a thumbs up if you like the value in these free tutorial videos that can make a big difference in your website. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.